I'm Ebony North for Investment Pitch Media. Golden Dawn Minerals has completed an initial review and target selection based on the VTEM geophysical survey of its Phoenix and Golden Crown properties at the Greenwood Precious Metals Project in southeastern BC. Golden Dawn, a near-term gold producer, has an extensive land package located east of Greenwood in southeastern British Columbia. In addition to the Phoenix and Golden Crown mines, these properties are extensively mineralized and cover 29 past producing mines and more than 70 mineral showings. The Phoenix camp also lies within the northern extension of the Republic Graben in northern Washington state, where several epithermal gold deposits and gold skarn deposits have been developed. The Kinross Gold's Buckhorn mine was the last to close in 2017 after producing approximately 1.3 million ounces of gold at an average grade of about 12 grams per ton gold between 2008 and 2017. Golden Dawn recently completed a review of the results from the helicopter-borne VTEM survey flown over the Phoenix and adjacent Golden Crown properties, which was designed to identify conductive areas to target a major copper-gold skarn deposit and or a porphyry-type copper-gold deposit. Christopher R. Anderson, CEO, stated, "The Phoenix mine is one of the largest historic copper-gold producers in southern BC. It has never had VTEM modern technology deployed on it before. In similar situations in southern BC, this technology has led to major new discoveries. The question has always been, where is the feeder source of the Phoenix Gold Copper Mine that historically produced 1 million ounces of gold and 5.9 million ounces of silver and over 235,000 tons of copper? It is now permitted for drilling. We are going to try and answer that question." The magnetic and electromagnetic survey results were investigated, considering the bedrock geology, distribution, and styles of known mineral occurrences. Magnetic results show strongly magnetic areas corresponding to extensions of outcropping intrusive rocks of the Nelson Plutonic Suite and ultramafic rocks of the Knob Hill Complex. Clusters of mineral deposits are recognized that appear to be related to interpretive margins of the Nelson Plutonic Suite and a structural zone extending northwest from gabbro and ultramafic rocks of the Knob Hill Complex. The Phoenix cluster surrounds the Phoenix mine open pit and is not clearly related to any strongly magnetic body. Extending west of Phoenix is an east-west trending zone of moderate to highly magnetic rocks that might signify intrusive rocks at depth. A highly magnetic area located east of Phoenix correlates with ultramafic rocks. The VTEM electromagnetic results show a series of conductive anomalies trending approximately east-west in the central portion of the block. Target areas were defined based on conductive high areas, with target areas 1, 2, 3, and 4 defining an easterly trend arc with a center that lies just north of the Phoenix open pit. These areas may represent bedrock mineralization related to blind intrusions and are selected as highest priority for follow-up exploration. Target Area 5 on the Golden Crown property will also require follow-up ground investigation. Follow-up work will include field examinations and permitting new sites, followed by ground EM and or IP geophysics, possible trenching, and diamond drilling. An exploration permit is currently in place for the Phoenix area that includes trenching and drilling for a total of 25 drill sites. An exploration permit is also in place for the Golden Crown property for a total of 35 drill sites. Multiple holes can be drilled from each of the sites, so the current permits allow for a total of up to approximately 21,000 meters. The shares are trading at 15 cents. For more information on these and the company's other projects, please visit goldendawnminerals.com. Contact Christopher R. Anderson, CEO, at 604-221-8936 or email office at goldendawnminerals.com. I'm Ebony North for Investment Pitch Media.